All marine mammals use sound in their lives to communicate, navigate, find food, detect predators, and maintain social networks. The sounds they produce have different acoustic qualities, like duration, loudness, and pitch. For example, dolphins produce high-pitched sounds to find their way around, while large whales produce low-pitched sounds to attract mates. Human industrial activities introduce sounds into the ocean. For example, shipping vessels produce sounds as a byproduct of their movement, while other sounds are more deliberately produced, like pile driving used for construction activities, and seismic air guns, which produce short pulses of sound that bounce off the seabed, providing information about whether there is oil beneath the ocean floor. So what is the impact of these sounds on marine species? The answer depends on a few factors, like the type of sound, how well the animal can hear the sound, what it was doing when it heard the sound, and whether it associated the sound with something harmful or benign. In some areas, like busy harbors, the noise from boats is so prevalent that it can interfere with animal communication. Scientists are busy trying to understand the influence that these different kinds of sounds have on marine mammals. Meanwhile, to predict potential impacts to animals, managers use models that include three components: when and where the sounds occur, when and where the animals are located, and how well the animals can hear the sounds. To build these models, we simulate the acoustic environment using information about the type of sound, water depth, and temperature and salinity of the water. We then include information about the density and distribution of animals to predict where they will be at any given time. Once we understand the overlap between the sound sources and the species of interest, we consider their hearing abilities to determine how much an animal could potentially be affected. The final step is to consider the vulnerability of the species based on other biological factors, like the health of their population, their mating periods, and their migration pathways, to evaluate how sensitive it would be to the additional stressor of man-made sounds. By considering the vulnerability of the species and the severity of acoustic impacts, we can evaluate the relative risk of man-made sounds on different marine mammal populations. From this analysis, we determine if an activity is too risky or whether protective measures can be put in place to adequately reduce the risk. After all, the more we know, the better we can protect marine life.